Oh my God, is it true that there is a microscopic mite that lives in your eyelashes? And it turns out, yes, there is a microorganism called a Demodex mite, and it loves to live at the base of your eyelashes and in the oil glands of your face. And unfortunately, these mites are linked to several other eye issues, including redness, itchiness, eyelid styes, meibomian gland dysfunction, and dry eye disease. But before you go running up to the mirror to find them or start freaking out, I have some really important news to share. So in today's video, we're going to talk about what this mite is, when it can become a problem, and of course, how to get rid of them. So first, what are Demodex mites? Well, Demodex mites are actually a family of small microscopic mites that love to live either in our hair follicles or in the sebaceous glands of our skin, where they consume and eat and live off of our skin oils. However, they are microscopic, meaning they're so small that even if you do run up to the mirror, there's no way you'll be able to identify them with the naked eye. You need a high-powered microscope in order to see them. But these mites are actually super common. In fact, almost everybody has these mites living on their face. Yes, even me right now, they're somewhere here. So I think it's important to mention here and understand that even though, yes, most of us have these mites living with us, they don't necessarily cause a problem, but they can cause some major issues, especially if they can overgrow, colonize, and more or less become an overgrowth in the eyelids and the lashes. What you're looking at here is a waxy crust that is built up on the base of somebody's eyelashes. When Demodex mites start to overgrow or infest the eyelashes, we start to identify what we call an eyelash collarette, which I hate to say is a buildup of Demodex eggs and body waste. Yeah, it's gross. But as an eye doctor, if we see this, it is considered a pathognomonic sign of an overgrowth or infestation of Demodex mites. And sadly, this has been found to affect up to 60% of people. In fact, the older you get, the more common it becomes, where if you're age 60 and older, you have at least an 80% chance of having it, and it's over 100% for people age 70 and older. However, I still see young people with this all the time, including high school and college students. But the real problem is that when these Demodex mites overgrow, they can cause a lot of other issues on the eye, namely that of inflammation in the eyelids, which can appear as redness on the eye or the eyelids themselves. It can also cause itchy sensation of the eyelids, which is usually worse in the early morning or at night when Demodex mites are most active. And if you caught our previous video all about eyelid styes, Demodex mites are also strongly associated with the development of both chalazions and hordeolums. And there's also a strong association with that of meibomian gland dysfunction leading toward dry eye disease. In fact, a lot of the patients I see for dry eye assessment also happen to have signs of Demodex blepharitis. And so we often start off treating the Demodex first before we can really kind of have a level playing field to treat the dry eye disease. So if your eye doctor ever sees these eyelash collarettes, then they may diagnose with what is called Demodex blepharitis and then proceed to talk about the various treatment options. Now, in fact, there's many different treatment strategies for managing Demodex blepharitis. Historically, the one that I think doctors have had the most access to is the use of eyelid hygiene cleaning using something that contains tea tree oil in it, as tea tree oil has been found to be effective at managing and getting rid of these mites. The downside, in my personal experience, along with many other of my colleagues, is that tea tree oil wipes and eyelid hygiene is sometimes not super effective. It seems to take several months of cleaning the eyelashes almost twice a day to even get a minimal response. And some people happen to be very sensitive or even allergic to tea tree oil, so it's not always an option. One technique that many eye doctors are now utilizing and may be able to offer is that of deep cleaning or a professional cleaning of the eyelids and lashes. This is usually done using special formulations of eyelid cleaning gels, as well as with a handheld tool to help debride and remove any of the eyelash collarette buildup. And they usually do this at least once a month, every month, while the patient is still simultaneously doing daily eyelid cleaning with a tea tree oil product until the mites have gone away. And this protocol has been shown in studies to be more effective. Now, perhaps you've seen this goofy commercial. In 2023, the US FDA approved the medication Xdemvy for the treatment of Demodex blepharitis. It contains a 0.25% lotilaner ingredient, which is an antiparasitic medication, which is prescribed as an eye drop twice a day for 6 weeks, and has been found to be extremely efficacious at eradicating these mites. And at least anecdotally, for the patients I've prescribed this for, not only have I seen resolution of the Demodex blepharitis, but I've also seen improvements in my patient's symptoms of irritation, of their itching, and then even the redness of their eyelids have improved. Sometimes insurance and price can be a barrier to this medication, but I think since it came out, it has been a game changer for a lot of people. And technically, it's the only treatment that's FDA approved for treatment of Demodex blepharitis, which I think is a great option for people who happen to have meibomian gland dysfunction, and perhaps they want to avoid needing another medication. And the one other medication I sometimes hear doctors prescribing is that of using ivermectin cream. However, while research does support its use, it still is not technically FDA approved for the treatment of Demodex blepharitis. But one thing about Demodex mites that's often not discussed is in fact its relationship to that of rosacea, which is an inflammatory skin condition that can also affect the eyes. So to learn more about rosacea, if that's something you think maybe you have or want to learn a little bit more about, go ahead and click or tap the screen right over here. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. Hope you learned something new. Keep an eye on it, and we'll see you in that video.